Hi children, now today we will discuss about the cellular respiration process. So every living cell need to perform cellular respiration. Then what is meant by cellular respiration? Let's see. Cellular respiration. So we have already studied that word, Nana. Oxygen will reach to each and every cell from the blood capillaries. In the gases exchange at cellular level we have studied. So oxygen entered into the cell, then each and every food molecule is brought into the cell from the blood. So by the blood, oxygen is brought into the cell and food molecule is brought into the cell. So inside the cell, this oxygen break up the chemical bonds of the food material which is entered into the cell. So this oxygen breaks the chemical bonds of the food material, chemical bonds of food material inside the cell. Then release what, Nana? Carbon dioxide gas plus water plus energy. So this energy is utilized by the cells to perform different activities of the cells. That's why it is very important to perform cellular respiration by each and every living cell. Each and every living cell need to perform cellular respiration. Why? Because to produce energy which is required to perform their activities. Okay. So if these respiration, cellular respiration depends on the oxygen level. If oxygen level supply is sufficient, the breakdown of food material takes place. So that is called aerobic respiration. That is called aerobic respiration. Means the breakdown of food material takes place in the presence of oxygen. Oxygen is present. So that is called aerobic respiration. If oxygen is not sufficient or absent, in that cases also food materials breaks down and release very less amount of energy. That is called what, Nana? Anaerobic respiration. That is called anaerobic respiration, or also called as fermentation. Also called as fermentation. So in the fermentation means what, Nana? Oxygen is absent and releases energy. In both the cases energy will be released, but in the aerobic respiration very huge amount of energy will be released, and in the anaerobic respiration very less amount of energy will be released. Okay. And this cellular respiration takes place in the entire cell cytoplasm, in very low level organisms like bacteria, yeast, etc. Means in their cytoplasm. Okay. So this cellular respiration takes place in cytoplasm, in the low level organisms like unicellular organisms like bacteria, yeast, etc. In the multicellular organisms like highly developed organisms, this cellular respiration takes place in the cytoplasm, few reactions, and also takes place in the mitochondria. Mitochondria. Okay, now. And this releasing of energy in the cellular respiration is not a simple step or simple reaction. It's a very complex process, and requires so many steps. And also the releasing of energy not takes place at a time. In each and every step, very less amount of energy released by the each and every step. Very less amount of energy released in each and every step by breakdown of complex materials into simple chemicals. In each and every chemical reaction, very complex materials divided into simple chemicals. In that each step, less amount of energy is released, and finally this energy stored in the form of a chemical component called ATP. Means that released energy, small amount of released energy forms ATP by bonding the third phosphate to the ADP. So this is ATP. So ATP is also called as what, na, energy currency, immediate energy for the cells. This is also called as energy currency. And whenever the released energy is stored in the ATPs, for further use, it can be stored in the different places. Whenever we require, whenever the cells are required ATP energy, so this ATP can break down and release the last phosphate and breaks the bond and gives the energy to perform the cell, that activities. Okay, and if you go the value of one ATP, one ATP can give almost 7200 calories of energy. Then what is this ATP? ATP is what, Nana? Adenosine triphosphate. Adenosine triphosphate. It's a chemical bond. You know that already in the earlier previous class we have studied what, Nana? Solar energy is stored in the form of chemical energy. So this is also a chemical energy. Okay? So in this way, cellular respiration can take place. Okay, stored energy in the form of ATPs whenever we require energy. So this ATP can breaks and gives 7200 calories of energy to perform the activities. Okay, now we'll discuss one more important topic about respiration, Nana. Let's see, for example, how these ATPs will work in our body. If you want to sprint and run a 100 meter race, so what will you do, Nana? You'll start 100 meter race. So will you start panting before starting the race or by standing on the track? No. Panting means what, Nana? Taking extra push-ups to fill the oxygen. Can you start panting before going to start the race? No. Then what we'll do? We'll start the race, 100 meter race. Then after finishing the race or after reaching the goal, then conditions are different. Based on your training level, based on how fast you run, you start panting for few minutes. Panting for few minutes to fulfill the oxygen deficiency in the blood. Okay? That time, what happens? How our body gets energy? So when the sprinter is doing a muscular work, so we require a lot of energy. So that is related to our ATPs. Generally, to perform that muscular work, our ATPs will break and gives energy. So but here, when we are doing a vigorous muscular work like a running of 100 meters race, all the ATPs in our body be utilized in a half second. Half second. Then how? What about the remaining energy of the muscles? So to understand this one, we need to go for one activity, Nana, experiment. So for this, we need to understand or we need to study the blood report of the athlete. Okay, we need to observe the blood report of an athlete. That's why we need to bring the athletes wherever the experiments we have. So we need to ask the athlete to pedal a cycle or run on a treadmill for a few minutes, almost for a 9 minutes. We need to ask the athlete to run on a pedal cycle or a treadmill for 9 minutes to do vigorous exercise. Okay, after doing the experiment and before the experiment and during the experiment, we need to take the blood sample of the athlete. We need to take the blood sample of the athlete and we need to observe the formation of lactic acid in the blood. Why the formation of lactic acid takes place? Okay, let's see. On the x-axis, we need to take the time in minutes. Okay, 5 10, 15, 20, etc. And on the y axis, we need to take the formation of lactic acid per millimeter cube, right? 20, 40, 80, 100, etc. So whenever that athlete doing a vigorous exercise, so ATPs will give energy, but in that vigorous exercise, all the ATPs can be utilized in half a second. Okay, then how the remaining energy will be produced? So whenever we are doing the exercise or running, athletes will stop breathing with a little extra breath, they'll start running. Then after reaching their goal, only they start panting. Means during the running, they can't take breath. So at that time, the glucose can be breakdown into, means there is no oxygen. So the glucose can be breakdown into another important component that is called lactic acid. Yes, and releases very less amount of energy. Very less amount of energy. And this energy can be utilized to form ADP, ATPs by bonding up ADP to the phosphate. So these ATPs can be utilized throughout the race. So then what is lactic acid? Why it is formed in our body? So to understand this one, we need to study what is happening in our cells and what are the steps involved in the cellular respiration. Let's see. Now, we already discussed what, Nana? Respiration, cellular respiration is what? It's a very complex process. Several steps involved in it. In each and every step, very less amount of energy is released. Okay, now? And in the multicellular organisms, that cellular respiration takes place in where, Nana? Cytoplasm. Cytoplasm plus mitochondria, and released energy is also stored in where, Nana? In the mitochondria in the form of ATPs. That's why these mitochondria are called what, Nana? Power houses of the cells. Mitochondria are called what, Nana? Power houses of the cells. Why? Because they store energy. That's why they are called as powerhouses of the cells. This is mitochondria. This is one of the important cell organelle. In the mitochondria only half of the reactions takes place and the energy stored in the form of ATPs in the mitochondria. Okay. Now let's see what happens in the cytoplasm and mitochondria. So first, generally, the 6-carboned glucose, C6H12O6, nana, glucose, it contains how many carbons? 6 carbons. So first, it breaks down into pyruvic acid or pyruvate. It breaks down into pyruvate, nana, plus releases a small amount of energy. So it's a 3-carboned material. Means 3 carbons pyruvate into 2 pieces. Okay, 2 molecules. So pyruvate and it releases energy. Whenever this pyruvic acid or pyruvate gets sufficient amount of oxygen, it releases carbon dioxide plus water plus high amount of energy. Okay, then whenever there is no oxygen availability or very less amount of availability of oxygen, this pyruvate breaks down into lactic acid plus very less amount of energy. It is possible in bacteria, and pyruvate breaks down into ethanol plus carbon dioxide plus energy. It is possible in the yeast. So this is the process happening in our kitchens. When we are preparing idli or dosa duff, we are getting carbon dioxide bubbles inside the duff. Okay, now, and even in the preparation of alcohols from the sugar industry, we are using this formula only. Okay, now, So whenever the glucose gets sufficient amount of oxygen, it breaks down into carbon dioxide plus water plus high amount of energy. Here very less amount of energy, almost 1/10 of the aerobic respiration energy. Okay, by the anaerobic respiration we'll get only 1/10 of energy. So here lactic acid is formed. This is also releasing energy. So similarly, like a bacteria, in our muscle cells also, just now we discussed in our activity, in our muscle cells also, when we are doing vigorous exercise, in a half second almost all the ATPs are utilized, and to complete the race, a remaining energy is given by the lactic acid formation. Pyruvate breaks down into lactic acid, okay, now in the absence of oxygen. So this lactic acid breaks down further and releases energy to supply ATPs. Okay, so because of this accumulation of ATPs only, we are able to complete the race. But what is happening here? After the completion of the race, athletes are getting what known as muscle cramp or muscle fatigue. Why? Because of this lactic acid only, we are getting what nana muscle cramp. The muscle cramp because of lactic acid. Then how can we get rid of this lactic acid after completion of race? Athletes need few minutes of rest and panting. Because of panting, he supplies sufficient amount of oxygen to remove the lactic acid. They need some amount of rest. Okay. So because of this rest only, lactic acid is removed. So during the activity, what is happening, Nana? First, we are using energy. Yes. And after that, we are supplying oxygen. Means we are facing the problem of oxygen debt during the running race. We are facing the problem of oxygen debt during the running race, and after the completion of race, we are repairing the oxygen debt by supplying lot of oxygen by the process of panting. Okay, now, so but this is not happening in the other long races. Why? Because during the long races, like 100, 200, 300 meters, 800 meters, during the race, athletes continuously taking the breath in the middle. That's why formation of lactic acid takes place, and the less amount of lactic acid is removed every time. Okay, that's why very less amount of lactic acid is formed and they feel very less stress. But in the 100 meters race, we are doing vigorous exercise. After the exercise, they face a lot of muscle cramp because of the formation of lactic acid. Okay, now for example, if you do a small exercise like this, take same length, nana, same distance to walk, speed walk, jogging, brisk walk, running, etc. Take the same distance, 100 meters distance, walk slowly, then brisk walk means a speedy walk, and jog and walk, so run and fast running. In all these cases, in which case you may face fatigue and you'll get a lot of muscle cramp? Obviously, whenever you run fast, obviously you'll get muscle cramp. Why? Because of formation of lactic acid. Okay, now, so in that graph also we have seen what, nana, if you see that graph, after doing it 9 minutes of exercise, what happened, nana? Formation of lactic acid is very high much rate. Okay, then after that, gradually the lactic acid level is decreasing. Why? Because, so this is our maximum level of lactic acid. Why? Because after doing the exercise, so he's taking rest with the extra push-ups, extra padding, means we are supplying the oxygen to reduce the oxygen depth. So lactic acid level is reducing and it comes to normal position after 40 to 60 minutes. Okay, now. Now, what is the capacity of our lungs? Okay, generally, if you go for our lungs capacity is what, nana? 5,800 milliliters. Means we can take almost 5000 milliliters of air at a time. But in generally, in the norm, this is a total capacity of the lungs. But in the normal position, in the relaxed position, every time we are taking only 500 ml of air inside every time. Okay? And if you breathe out completely, means if you remove all the air from your lungs, still our lungs hold 1200 ml of air inside the lungs. So this is the capacity of our lungs. Then, one more important question. So, if you observe sometimes the mountain trekking mountaineers or scuba diving athletes or scuba diving persons, etc., they carry some oxygen cylinders on their back. Why? So, we have already studied what on the sea level, almost all the oxygen molecules will bond up with all the hemoglobin molecules. So at the atmosphere, in the atmosphere, almost 21% of oxygen is there at the sea level. Okay, this is a sea level. In the sea level, all the molecules of oxygen is satisfied with the hemoglobin, so there is no problem. Then from the sea level, if you go to 13 kilometers or 8 miles height, almost the oxygen levels reduce to the 1/5. So oxygen level reduced to 1/5 of the atmospheric oxygen at the height of 13 kilometers. Okay, now at that height, what happens when almost only half of the oxygen molecules can bond up with the hemoglobin. Now, hemoglobin is unable to supply, our blood is unable to supply sufficient amount of oxygen to the cells. Now, here cells also feeling what nana? Less amount of supply of oxygen. If oxygen is not supplied, energy is not produced. We may suffocate, etc. That's why they carry the oxygen cylinders on their back. Even scuba divers also will face different kinds of problems. Then if you observe modern aeroplanes, etc., they have pressurized oxygen chambers in them. Why? Because they are going on a different heights. So there the passengers will face an oxygen depth problem. That's why they have some pressurized oxygen chambers in them to supply sufficient oxygen to them. Okay. So that's it for today's topic, Nana. If you have any queries and doubts regarding the topic, please text in the comment box. Thank you.